Hi friends, good morning to all. This is Vahida, working as an assistant professor in ECE department in Chebrolu Engineering College. And in today lecture, I am going to discussing about register transfer. Okay. In previous lecture, we discuss about how the data path inside a processor. So within a processor, we are having program counter, address register, data register, along with this ALU and control unit and some n number of general purpose register. So, okay. So, along with this, we are also having three temporary registers. Those are Y, Z and temp. These are the three temporary register. Along with these three registers, we also have one multiplexer. Okay, so these all are present inside a processor. And also we know that how a single bus, means a single internal bus, is connected with all these registers inside a processor. Okay, so from this topic we are discussing how the data is transferred within a processor. Okay, so from one register to other register, or from one register to the ALU, or from ALU to the other register. Okay, and also a control unit is used to control the remaining registers or the remaining parts or the remaining devices within a processor. And in today lecture, we are discussing register transfer, means how the data is transferred from one register to other register. An instruction execution involves a sequence of steps. In order to execute an instruction, we have to follow some sequence of steps in which data are transferred from one register to another register. For each register, we are having two control signals are used to place the content of the register on the bus or to load the data on the bus into the register. Okay, so in order to transfer the data from one register to other register, each register has two control signals. Okay, so by using those control signals, a register places the data onto the bus. Okay, and next, so from bus, okay, the data is loaded on the bus into the register by using two control signals. Okay, see those control signals. So here I am having R1 register. For this R1 register, the two control signals, first control signal is RI suffix in, means this is input control signal for RI register. And next here another control signal, that is RI out. Okay, means out control signal for RI register. So by using RI in control signal, if RI in is set to 1, okay, so during this situation, the data on this internal processor bus is going to be loaded into this RI register. Okay, see, whenever the input control signal is set to 1, the data on the bus are loaded into the RI register. Similarly, when RI out is set to 1, okay, so whenever out control signal is set to 1 is high, this situation, in this situation, The content of the register or I is placed onto the bus. Okay, see, so whenever input control signal is set to 1 or RI is high, this situation the data on the bus is loaded into the RI register. Whenever the output control signal is high, the data in this RI register is placed onto the bus. Okay, so in this manner we will transfer the data from one register to other register. So here the register is RI register, so that we are having the two control signals are RI in control signal, RI out control signal. Suppose if I have R1 register, okay, so R1 register have the two control signals, those are R1 in control signal and R1 out control signal. Okay, so suppose for R4 register have R4 in and R4 out control signal. Each and every register has two control signal. By using those control signal, the data or the content of register on the bus, okay, or loaded the data on the bus into the register. So suppose if I want to transfer transfer the content of register R1 to R4. Suppose in R4 register I have some data. Now I want to transfer the data in R1 register into R4. So first what we have to do, whatever the data is present in the R1 register, first it is transferred into the processor internal bus. Okay, so in order to transfer the data which is present in R1 register into the processor internal bus, which control signal we have to activate it? See, here now the data is transferring from register to bus. From register to bus data transferring, we have to activate the output control signal. Okay, so in order to transferring the data from register to bus, we have to activate the output control signal. So what we have to do? First, we have to enable the output of register R1 by setting R1 out to 1. Okay, by setting R1 out to 1, what will happen? The content of R1 register is transferred to the processor internal bus. Okay, now whatever the content present in R1 register is transferred to the processor internal bus. Okay, now what we have to do? From processor internal bus, the data is transferred to the R4 register. See, here what we are doing? From processor internal bus, the data is transferred to R4 register. So now what we have to do means enable the input of the register R4. Means we have to set R4 into high or 1. Okay, so whenever the R4 in control signal is activated, then whatever the data present in the processor internal bus is transferred to the R4 register. Okay, so in order to transferring the content of R4 register to R1 register to R4, first we have to transfer the data in R1 register into the processor internal bus. For that transfer, we have to activate R1 out control signal to high. Next, we have to transfer the data from processor internal bus to the R4 register. We can't directly transfer the data direct from R1 to R4. We can't transfer. We will transfer the data from one register to other register by using processor internal bus. So first we placed the data in R1 register to processor internal bus. Next step, we have to transfer the data in processor internal bus into the R4 register. For that operation, we have to activate R4 in control signal to high. Okay, so all these operations and data transfer within a processor take place within time periods. Okay, so all these operations are going to be performed within time periods defined by the processor clock. The control signals that governs a particular transfer are asserted at the start of the clock cycle. Okay, so in our example, R1 out and R4 in are set to high. Okay, so in this example, we are setting R1 out and also R4 in control signals to 1. The registers consists of edge triggered flip flop. See, each and every register contains an edge triggered flip flop. Hence, at the next active edge of the clock, the flip flops that constitute R4 will load data present at their inputs. At the same time, the control signals R1 out and R4 in will return to 0. Once the data transfer is completed, then the control signals R1 out and R4 in will return to 0. For example, data transfer may use both rising and falling edges of the clock. Also, when edge triggered flip-flops are not used, in this condition we have to use two or more clock signals may be needed to guarantee a proper data transfer. So in order to transfer the data here, for each and the registers are uses the edge triggered flip-flops. They may be either rising edge or falling edge. So if edge triggered flip-flops are not used, then two or more clock signals may be needed in order to guarantee the proper transfer of the data. This is known as multi-phase clocking. So if we are increasing the clock pulses, means it comes under the multi-phase clocking. See, so this is the one bit of a register RI. Okay, so the register RI, each and every register is designed in this way by using edge triggered flip flop. Here we are using D flip flop, that to positive edge triggered D flip flop. Okay, so by using here D flip flop, we are implementing the RI register. A two input multiplexer, here in this we are using a two input multiplexer is used. So why we are using a two input multiplexer means it is used to select the data applied to the input of the edge triggered flip flop. Okay, so for this register the data comes from this two input multiplexer. Okay, so the two input multiplexer is used in order to select the data that is applied to the input of an edge triggered D flip flop. See, when the control input RI in, so this is the RI in control signal, whenever RI in is equal to 1, then the multiplexer will select the data which is present on the bus. Okay, so whenever RI in is set, then the multiplexer will select the data which is present in the processor internal bus. So this is the processor internal bus. So the data which is present in the processor internal bus is transferred to the edge triggered flip-flop through multiplexer. Okay, so whenever RI in is equal to 1, the multiplexer select the data on the bus. Okay, now this data will be loaded into the flip-flop at rising edge. Here we are taking a rising edge of the clock pulse. Okay, so whenever RI in is 0, okay, so whenever RI in is 0, then these 2x1 multiplexer will select. Okay, so the multiplexer feed back the value currently stored in the flip flop. Okay, so whenever RI in is 0, then the multiplexer will select the 0th input. So which is the data which is present in this register is fed back to this multiplexer. Means the content of the flip-flop will not be changed when RI in is equal to 0. Only when RI in is equal to 1, this condition only, this multiplexer will select the data which is present in this processor internal bus. Okay. And that data is transferred to the register. When RI in is equal to 0, then the data which is present in these edge triggered flip-flop will never get changes. Okay. And next, the Q output. The output Q of the flip-flop is connected to bus via a tri-state gate. Here we are also used a tri-state gate. Okay, so register containing a edge triggered flip-flop and 2x1 multiplexer, along with this it also contain tri-state gate. Okay, so the output of this register is going to be connected to the bus through a tri-state gate. When RI out, okay, so whenever this RI out is equal to 0, then the gate and then the output Q is in the high impedance. The gate's output is in high impedance. Means it is electrically disconnected state. Okay, so this corresponds to open circuit state of a switch. Whenever RI out is 0, then the gate's output is in high impedance state. Means it corresponds to the open circuit state, like a switch, open circuit. Okay, so this situation, the data from the register is not transferred to bus. Okay, so whenever RI out is set to 1, whenever RI out is equal to 1, then this tri-state gate drives the bus to either 0 or 1 depending on the value Q. Okay, so whenever RI out is equal to 0, then this gate will be open circuit, means it is at high impedance state. Because of high impedance state, the gate will be open circuit. During this situation, the data will not be transferred from this register to the processor internal bus. Whenever RI out is equal to 1, in this situation only the gate will drive the data which is present in this register into the processor internal bus. Okay, so each and every register has two control signals. Those are input and output control signals. For transferring the data from one register to other register, so must and should we have to transfer the data by using through an internal processor internal bus. For transferring the data from register to processor internal bus, we have to activate the output control signal of that corresponding register. In order to transferring the data from processor internal bus to the register, we have to activate the corresponding input control signal of that register. Okay, so the register is going to be designed by using either rising edge or falling edge triggered flip-flop. Along with this edge triggered flip-flop, the register will also contain a 2x1 multiplexer and a tri-state gate. Okay, so depending on these control signals, input and output control signals, the data may be transferred from register to the processor internal bus or from processor internal bus to the register. So this is the how the data is transferred from one register to other register within a processor. See, here the data is transferred from one register to other register within a processor by using processor internal bus. Okay, so this is the register transfer operation. Okay, so in next lecture, so once the data is transferred to the ALU has to perform the operation. In next lecture, we will look how ALU will perform the arithmetic and logical operation. Okay, so that means how the data is transferred to the ALU and how ALU will perform arithmetic and logical operation. This we will look in next lecture. So if you understand the register transfers, how the data is transferred in between one register to other register, then it is very helpful to understand how the data is transferring to the ALU. Okay, so once all the operands are transferred to the ALU, ALU will perform the operation according to the instruction which is stored in the instruction register. Okay, so the ALU operations and the data transferring, how the data is transferred to the ALU. So this we will look in our next lecture. Okay, thank you.